direct order. Do it now.
From now, this was a battleground where India was fighting one of its toughest wars ever. The task was to dislodge well-entrenched enemy troops from these heights, something which seemed impossible on paper but was made possible. In the next half an hour, we will revisit the war which redefined mountain warfare and changed India's battle history.
I wanted to walk the same steps which I, along with my men, had walked during Kargil war. I am extremely happy and emotional too that today I am driving a vehicle and going towards the point which I had captured, but for which 10 years back I had to struggle so much and my boys had to lay down their lives.
For his men and for the memories of a war, Colonel Ajit Singh retraces the path to point 4812, the 17,500 feet high peak in Watalik, which they captured on the 3rd of July 1999. Singh was then a major, commanding a company of 22 grenadiers, and the target was cut out.
The area which we were given is that snow-clad area. That is the top which you see the snow. That is 0.5287, and onto its left you see a biggish rock. That is the place which we were aiming for.
A decade ago, it was a 24 kilometers climb from the base of this trackless mountain. Now it's just an hour's drive.
This was beyond imagination. I could never imagine that there would be a road which will be leading to point 4812, and it would take only an hour or little less than that for capturing which we had taken more than around 12 hours.
Other than the road, the mountains have not changed much. The remnants of the battle are still all around. A rusty splinter or a rock that saved their lives.
I just want to take you towards this rock where the people used to take on, some rest or respite. There are some remnants of some peat shoes or things like that. The moment the enemy used to start firing or the enemy shelling was there, you used to do this.
Their attack was launched on the night of June 30th. Before daybreak, the men had to reach the peak. The closer they inched, heavier was the enemy fire. Singh says the troops used it all. Military strategy, bravado, and even divine help.
When we were around 50 to 75 meters short of the peak or short of the top, the climb had become very difficult. There was a straight cliff in front of us, and the fire of the enemy was coming from all three sides, that is front and the two spurs on the right. We were very close, and we could hear the enemy trying to open the ammunition boxes. There was rumbling down of stones, and the enemy was trying to throw stones also at us.
The war had started earlier in May 1999, after over 5,000 Pakistani intruders strategically occupied Indian heights. They were spread along nearly 180 kilometers of these ridges, anywhere between 16,000 to 18,000 feet. For the Indian side, the task was uphill. Barely 150 kilometers away, Indras 2, the guns were raging.
Indras, the Pakistani intruders had taken positions very close to this National Highway 1A, like the Tololing range here, which was barely 3 kilometers away. The aim was to cut off this crucial Leh-Srinagar link.
The Indian Army launched the first offensive here at Tololing Peak, aiming to restore the national highway. First, they failed. But 3 weeks later, on June 17th, Tololing was recaptured. The victory which made way towards point 5140, Three Pimples, Bathra Top, and Tiger Hill.